Can I hear it for Life Sucks? Wow! Life Sucks theory of political mortification holds that if you give the average meatball a choice between sautéed breast of welfare child and a dumpster buffet in the alley behind Le Cirque, he'll order them both and still have room for an average meatball. Is that starting to sound familiar? Has anybody even noticed we're in hell? The newspaper appears when it's supposed to. You hurry past the darkness to the safety of the sports section. As dawn filters through the dirty air, you cram yourself into an underground box, putrid with the stench of the lost and desperate. The earth vomits you up and you head straight to the nearest Formica line closet where you can score a cup of coffee, your first drug of the morning. The waitress has just begun a 12-hour day of standing. Her smile is a special effect she's been working on since she came to realize that her life consisted of swimming in a school of hopeful dancers from audition to audition, living on callbacks and caffeine. Her name is Heather, and she'll be happy to serve you for minimum wage and a handful of change electronically calculated with dead precision. You're in hell, all right, and it sucks. But that doesn't bother you, does it? Because at least you have health coverage in your own little cubicle, in a double row of cubicles back to back. It's like heaven for cows. Has anyone squeezed your tits at work lately? Do they count the number of times you piss and shit? Do you ever see the sunlight? When someone tells you not to spend your paycheck all in one place, how many minutes, how many hours does it take for you to stop laughing hysterically? Do you spend all day walking on your fingertips, or do you get to hunt the poor? You are now entering a thought-free zone. Buy stuff. Don't ask questions. But every week, they pay you less and less, so they can charge less and less for the stuff you make, so you could buy more of it if they weren't paying you less. Don't worry, though, they aren't charging less after all, so you really do serve a higher purpose, like a carrot doing a swan dive into the juicer. And any Midwest megachurch will be glad to help you scrape the bottom of your wallet in return for letting you know that life sucks, and it's all your fault. If you'd waited till you got married, the air would be pure. If you hadn't smoked that joint, there wouldn't be any homeless. If you'd stopped reading Playboy or Cosmo, everyone's wages would double and double again. If you beat your kids more, the LA cops would be poster boys for love. If you just hadn't had that abortion, hadn't come out, hadn't studied Darwin, hadn't voted for that great Satan in the White House, then this earth would be a kingdom of grace and joy, and your life wouldn't suck nearly so bad anymore. Have you had enough yet? Will you ever have enough even once in your miserable life? When will you raise your hand to take back what you were born to have? Life sucks. The rest is up to you. I wrote this in the middle of an otherwise complete absence of poetry for a couple of months last fall, so I guess this is a poem in the shape of a writer's block. I call it Tantrum. Had I known, had I but known, had I grown, had I had no small. Move a little closer to the light and start over. Had I known, had I but known, had I grown, had I had no small fists on the back of a chair, pounding the future into grime. No haddock, no headache, no pounding mounds into flat dust, no view, no horizon, nothing on it. Hopping, stomping, pounding, grounding, grinding teeth into grinding teeth into shard, sharp, glittering, melting onto the waste, landing in shade. No trousers roused, rounded, bounding into the tusk. Brows pondering, face melting, sagging under the weight of thought. No cries in the wilderness. No sex, no love, no emptiness, no room for nothing. No space, no time, no being, pulling the surfaces of things in on themselves, down into a saddle, riding, priding, bucking, braiding, sinking, shrinking, placing the grace in the glass, empty and dusty, standing in lost majesty, waiting for thirst. No room, no in, no out. out, no peg, no hole, no square, no shape, no definition, no fields of energy protecting us from themselves, no drive, no crystal, no future heading back at us, rebounding from the end of things, no distortion, no lumps in the blanket of stars, no texture, no gravity, no black hole, no white dwarf, no red mist filling the path of the planet. No test, no tax, no treasure, no pain, no gain, no grain, no icing, dicing, surprising us with the thoughts of matter, inert, solid, solid, bounded, braced, triggered, treasured, laved and lathered, graced and gathered, bothered, and I don't know, no, no halves done by, no quarters given, no dollars folded, no X, no Y, no graph, no plot, no character, no ending, no beginning, no turns, no twists, no lemons, no limes, no stirring, no shaking, no smoking, no faking, nothing under the hood, in the divine, out of your mind, down the alley, up your nose, flaking, dissolving, being absorbed in the study of instant happiness and chronic sorrow. Borrow tomorrow against today, and there's no payback, no slingback, no black, no blade, no shade, no currents, no events, nothing doing, nobody knows, trouble, bubble, Bible, babble, swing. And there's still no company, no firm touch, no music, no bus, no beat, no sheet, sliding, satin, no caressing, undressing, learning, burning, turning care into misery, mystery, history, herstory, no Scheherazade, no promenade, no lemonade being made in the shade, no rhyme, no rhythm, no syncopation, no sensation, no sleep, no waking, no walking, no taking on the obligation, no reiteration of deep thoughts pasted in light behind a glass front, no dump, no piss, no shit.
Thank you.
No erection, no infection, no body nodding, prodding grace into motion, no notion of what not to do, no plan, no direction, no weatherman, no feather and no pleasure, nothing at all, no one to ball, no crisis rising, dries or alive and pressed in the pages of suffering, solace, solitary, arbitrary, arbitration, negation of agreement on the mount of skulls, dragging symbolism down to the street to a predetermined end of what I value most in the world. And I take a deep breath, and I'm still here. I wrote this, as a historical note, I wrote this on April 12th, 1997, and it's called Last Night. Last night I dressed up as a poet and went to the party at the center of life, and there you were, spinning, smiling, conquering worlds, turning shit into music, as I checked my costume and rehearsed my repertoire of wise expressions. Last night, I dressed up as a poet and joined the parade trailing after you down night-clotted streets, past the tombs of silent dreamers, through unexpected gardens of brick and concrete, gazing at you helpless and smoky-eyed as you carelessly enchanted them. I hardly dared to move or speak, or most of all to laugh, for fear of spilling the wonder from my soul. Last night I dressed up as a poet and drank in everything I'd ever want to write about. All the love and loss and fear and triumph, intoxication and regret, hope and resentment, states of stillness and motion, hours steeped in coffee, days of toil and vision, torrents of word and image, the discovery of new lands, the joyful noise of a life under construction. And if I had the chance, I'd do it again forever, dressed up as a poet and ready for anything. And I'm going to finish up with this one because it's in big print. Big, dark print. It's called, I Don't Need Love. I could settle for the casual cruelty of your friendship if I could just find some way to pry myself loose from the scenery. If you thought more of me, or maybe less, whatever it might take. If you could see the pain in my eyes whenever something hurts you. Only once I would touch your hand and then I would swear off forever. I would dream only of paper women or colored glass. I wouldn't miss anything, I promise. Like you, I have walked alone through darkness and danger. I have shattered myself against the emptiness and pieced myself haphazardly together again. I have bitten the thorn and drunk of myself, and I have memorized the taste of salt. I don't need love anymore. I only need you.